Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Devil says, I was glad, I'm very glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord today. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We are in the presence of the Lord. I'm just going to praise Him together. Amen.
Thank you. Oh, Jesus, you are a wonderful King. We adore your holy name. Let's sing Hosanna, 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 you are faithful. We adore
brother.
Thank you. Thank you to Papa and Mama for a wonderful opportunity bringing me to Melbourne, and they've introduced me to many men and women of God, and I'm so humbled to be given an opportunity to be able to stand here and be able to minister. Amen.
Amen.
I hope that I'll be relevant, and I won't disappoint you, Papa. Yeah, you know, I just believe in life that, you know, there's always a due season. God doesn't just send you somewhere for no reason. It's always a reason. And I believe that it was at an appointed time that I'll be here today. And I know that what I'm going to be doing here, it'll be all God's will. Amen. I'm going to share a song that is called Worry Not. It's upon my heart. And this is a song that I feel I really, really want to share. And why do I want to share a song called Worry Not? Each and every one of us in here, at some point in life, we worry. We have bills. Some are dealing with immigration issues. Others, we are looking for jobs. Others, they are doing business. There's always someone somewhere where worry comes in. But you know, when we worry, we die a little every day. And the Bible is always against worry, because when you look at when you go to John chapter 4, the Bible says, let not your heart be troubled. So worry the word of God is again as water. And when you go to Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, you hear the word of God is saying, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication and thanksgiving in our hearts, make your prayer because be made known unto God. And He will give us the peace that is beyond human understanding. Not the peace that the world gives, but the peace that is only from God, that is beyond human understanding. But even though we read the word of God, the worry still comes. And what I came to learn is that when I became a believer, I thought when you become a believer, you have no devils to fight in your life. Mm-hmm. I missed it. Now I've learned because the life of Jesus, all his life he was fighting the enemy. So if the Son of God was fighting the enemy, that entails you, my brother and my sister, that we are on a battle, but it's a spiritual battle. And this is the reason why we have to keep fighting. We cannot give up. And the song that I'm going to sing, it says, worry not. Because we know that our God is able and is more than able. In Ephesians 3, verse 20, the Bible says that he's able to give exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask for. So even things that we cannot ask for, he's able to give us. When you go to Matthew chapter 6 and you go to the verse of 32 and 33, it says, the pagans, they search for all these things, the material things and all these things. But the Heavenly Father, he knows that you and I, we need them, because all silver and gold belongs to him. And when you go in 33, the Bible says, but seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you as well. Meaning the things that you're worrying about, he shall give you. Even the things that you don't know, that they are coming, they are on their way. And this is why the Bible says, begin to call things that were not as though they were. Amen. Amen. So here is the song that I'm going to sing. It goes like this. When I say, I'll worry no more, you say, I'll worry no more. So, I'll worry no more. Then you respond,
I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
Then when I go to the next part, I know my God is able. You say, he is more than able. I know my God is able.
He is more than able.
I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
You have to sing like you mean it. Because you know what I believe? As I'm singing, God is doing something in your life. God is doing something. Something is changing somewhere. Something is changing somewhere. I believe you come and give a testimony here. Amen. So, I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
Yeah, I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
I know my God is able.
He's more than able.
You know your God is able.
He's more than able.
Yeah, I'll worry no more.
I'll worry no more.
I know my God is able.
He's more than able.
You know your God is able.
He's more than able.
Now there's this part that I enjoy the most. It goes like this. If he feeds the birds of the air, heals every disease, breaks the yoke of bondage, and the devil is put to shame, why worry? I know you can do it. We will do it bit by bit, but we'll get there. So, if he feeds the birds of the air, heals every disease, breaks the yoke of bondage, and the devil is put to shame. Why worry? Now when you say, why, you should be smiling. Because you are confirmed it already. If he feeds the birds of the air that do not even do anything, and he heals every disease 2,000 years ago, by his stripes we were healed, and he breaks the yoke of bondage, and the devil has been put to shame. Why worry? And then when we go back to Africa now, you know, my language is very interesting. We say, so you go like this. You mention the name of God, you go, he's a king of kings, a lord of lords. Then you go in my language, maybe I say, Amwine Timba Milonga Mwine Rubanza. Then because the name of God is too big, when you're saying Ashaka Shaka, you are shaking as you are dancing. So, a king of kings, a lord of lords, mwine rubansa, achimba milonga, ashaka shaka, ayoka. It's too big, it's too big. So, if he feeds the breath of the air, heals every disease, you can help me,
Break the yoke of bondage and the devil is put to shame. Why worry?
We can do this one too.
If he feeds the brethren, heals every disease. Break the yoke of bondage and the devil is put to shame. Why worry?
Then you can say,
I've never seen a righteous man go beg for bread. Never.
You can do that.
I've never seen a righteous man go beg for bread. Never.
You have to do the never. Because you believe what you're saying.
I've never seen a righteous man go beg for bread. Never.
Then you go.
If he feeds the bread of the air, use every disease. Break the yoke of bondage and the devil is put to shame. Why worry?
So
I'm worried no more.
I'm worried no more.
I know my God is able.
I know my God is able.
You know your God is able.
He is more than able.
I've never seen a righteous man go beg for bread. Never.
If he feeds the bread.
If he feeds the bread of the air. Use every disease, break the yoke of bondage, and the devil is put to shame. Why worry?
Now the song is gonna be played, so I'll be asking the men and women of God to please are standing with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters,
we can raise it how?
He surely has spoken.
You can raise the volume.
Worry about your life. For who among us can
add an hour to their life by worry?
Why don't you rise up, lift up your voice, and praise him? Let me hear you scream.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. Pastor Christine has given us a word, the Lord is my shepherd, and this is my BMK, also more or less preached. Don't worry, hallelujah. Amen. Don't be anxious for anything. It's time for the Lord's Supper, please. Let's rise up on our feet. Let's spend some few minutes in prayer before we go to the Lord's table. Let's pray. Let's prepare ourselves. Do some confessions. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Let's lift your voice and call upon Jehovah. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run unto it. Let's pray. Let's prepare ourselves for the Lord's table. Father, we bless you, Lord. We thank you and we honor you. We exalt your name. There is no other God like you. We bless you as we come before your presence. We lift up your name because there's no name like Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Forgive us all our iniquities, all our transgressions. Jesus was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment of God has paid was upon him. By his stripes we are healed. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Let's sing it together. Oh, the singers, please.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, the blood. The blood of Jesus washes white as snow. Let's sing it together one more time. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood. Oh, Jesus. People of God, the only person who cannot go to the Lord's table is the unbeliever. Hallelujah. Every Christian has the right to go to the Lord's table. Hallelujah. But Paul told us to examine ourselves. Hallelujah. Before coming to the Lord's table, Paul told us, the Corinthians, examine yourselves. Hallelujah. Before you come to the Lord's table. I just want to read some scripture. Let's sit down. I'll go through very fast and 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 28. Paul says that, okay, let's start from verse 27. Therefore, whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. Verse 28. But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. Verse 30. For this reason, many are weak, many are sick among you, and many are asleep. Hallelujah. For if we will judge ourselves, we will not be judged. Hallelujah. So, this I don't have to explain this. It's obvious. Hallelujah. Examine yourself before coming to the Lord's table. Please, can you unveil there? Because of time, I'll make it very fast, but we've got some few minutes to finish it off. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, Lord, this cup is symbolic of your blood, the bread symbolic of your body. The Bible tells you, Lord, before the Israelites were leaving Egypt, you commanded Moses to tell his people to kill sheep without blemish and to apply the blood on their doorposts. Father, the Bible says they obey your voice and did exactly what you told them to do. And because of that, Lord, none of them were feeble. Hallelujah. Father, I just want to thank you for the blood and I thank you for the body of Jesus. Even as we partake this emblem, this afternoon, I pray that even those who are sick will be healed. Those who are possessed will be delivered by the power of the blood of Jesus. I pray, Lord, even as we partake this, Lord, doors will be opened, Lord. The Bible says Jesus holds the keys of David. When he opened the door, no one shut it. And when he shut the door, no one can open it, Lord. I just want to thank you for what you've done. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm moving very fast. All right. Verse 23, it says that, for I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that he, the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken. For you do this in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. It's good to go to the Lord's table. I know there are a lot of Christians who doesn't want to go for some reasons, hallelujah. But I want to encourage each and everyone here to go to the Lord's table, hallelujah. We are talking about the blood of Jesus here and the body of Jesus. I don't know how you see it. The Bible says that in the book of Revelation 12, the devil was defeated by the blood of Jesus and the word of their testimony, hallelujah. Whatever that you are going through in life, I know all that you need is the blood. Hallelujah. We need the blood. We have got the name of Jesus. But the blood is so powerful. Hallelujah. Let's rise up. If you have got the bread and the cup, please let's rise up. Let's rise up. Let's rise up, people of God. Hallelujah. Now let's lift the bread. Lift the bread. The Bible says, when he has given thanks, he broke it and said, take it. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Let's partake the bread. People of God, let's take it. Let's partake the bread. Hallelujah. He said, in the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. People, well, let's partake the cup as well. Hallelujah. If you read the book of Matthew 27, 26, it said that after they partake the supper, they sang hymns, hallelujah. They sang hymns. You have some songs for us? Oh, the blood, one more time. Of Jesus. Yeah, okay, can you join us? Of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. We perish for lack of knowledge. Hallelujah. When Pastor Gustin was talking about, he was preaching here, he was talking about, there are some things that, I mean, you can go to churches, they are ignorant, they have no idea about what is going on. Hallelujah. Let's read verse 26. The Bible says that, 7:26, my Bible says, but the court shall be seated, and they shall take away the dominion to consume and destroy it forever. I'll go slowly. You know, when God created Adam and Eve, God gave them power, dominion to rule over the whole creation. Hallelujah. But when Adam sinned, he actually gave everything back to Satan. So the devil was handling everything. Lose this. Hallelujah. So Jesus came to the sin and brought back what Adam lost. Hallelujah. Here, Daniel's source of visions. I won't go to the visions. I just want to go to the interpretation as well. The Bible says that the court shall be seated. I read from verse 27. Then the kingdom and dominion and greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven. Hallelujah. Under the whole heaven. That means heaven is not part of it. This earth. Shall be given to the people, the saints of the Most High. Hallelujah. So those power, no, the devil, I don't know, a lot of Christians are afraid of Satan, the devil. But the devil is not afraid of us. Those, every power on this earth is given to us, Christians. That's what Jesus did. Hallelujah. His resurrection, he brought every power that we lost, lose this, back to us. Hallelujah. So, I want us to pray. Look, there are some things that I wanted to talk about. God actually giving revelations through the Holy Ghost. Because when Jesus was risen from the dead, the Bible says that Mary Magdalene saw Jesus and he couldn't recognize him. Jesus has actually said, Mary, this is me. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. If you read the book of Luke chapter 24, the Bible says that there was one guy called Cleopas. He was going to Emmaus, a village. There were two people walking. Jesus was walking with them, but they didn't even recognize Jesus Christ. Jesus spoke with them the whole day, but Christ has to reveal himself to them that I am Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, the Bible says the word of God is Jesus himself. The word came flesh and made his dwelling among us. The power is you. If Jesus, the Lord, if Christ himself doesn't give us a revelation about this book, we can hold it years and never get anything from the book. Hallelujah. We need revelations from Jesus. Hallelujah. I wanted to pray a very short prayer. Ask God, Lord, this year, I want to know more about Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Paul said, I want to know Jesus and the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah. Now, what I read is now, he's telling me that the devil has no more dominion for him anymore. All the power, God has given the power to all of us here. The saints. Who is the saint? You are a saint. Hallelujah. You are a righteous man. I know some preachers are preaching that, Lord, unless you do that, before you can be a righteous man. So, Jesus, we are righteous because of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our righteousness is not by works. It's by grace. Listen very, very careful. Isaiah said, our righteousness are like filthy rags. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are able to go to Jesus because we are righteous. Hallelujah. Somebody paid the price 2,000 years ago. I mean, let's pray. We need God to give us a revelation about Jesus. Pray. That's the prayer I want to do before we finish the service. Say, God, give me a revelation about Jesus. I want to know his power, the power of his resurrection. Let's pray. Let's just call upon Jehovah. God, I want to know Jesus. I want to know him. I want to know him. I want to know Jesus. I want to know this Jesus. Unless he gives us a revelation about himself. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to know him and the power of his resurrection, God, to share in his sufferings and to be like him. I just want to thank you, Lord. I just want to bless you. I just want to honor you for answering prayers in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Please, can you spare us about 5 minutes of your time today? Hallelujah.
Amen.
We normally finish 5 o'clock, but please give me 5 more minutes. Let's welcome our elder who has a word for the youth. Please, let's be seated, people of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
Oh, you people, you're not talking like you are resurrected people.
Hey, God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Our God is good. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. Oh my God, today it was really wonderful. Wonderful.
Yeah.
This is like the church in the book of Acts, where people were just in the house of God and worshiping God, and those preachers, the Peters and the Pauls, they were preaching and preaching from morning until sunset. And these people, they never went and they never left. Amen? So, Pastor, you were really right. Thank you so much for that. And my brother, thank you that we should not even worry, but just eat this food. Amen? The reason why I came here is about the youth. We've got some wonderful, wonderful children here. And God is doing marvelous, marvelous things. And for me, it is my greatest joy to see young people doing the work of God. Amen? Because these are the future leaders of tomorrow. These are the future parents of tomorrow. These are our future leaders, pastors, ministers of tomorrow. Amen? So they have to be soaked in the word of God. And these people, they are living in dangerous times as compared to us. Because we are here in Australia. Some of us, we grew up in Africa, where we had rules and we were following the traditional rules, and it's managed to keep us safe. Amen? Amen? But here in this country, there's so much. There's so much that our children are exposed to. There is internet, there are drugs, there are taught of sex in school, they are taught of so many things, some of the things that we were never taught. But if our children are rooted in the word of God, my goodness, nothing will touch them. Amen? Amen? So I'm just saying, we've got wonderful youth here, and some of them, when they started coming to this church, they were so shy that they could not even come and stand here. But thank God that these children that you see here, they are doing wonderful things. Amen? Amen. And some of them, we've got preachers here in this church who are preaching the word of God. And when you come one of these days, you'll find one of the young guys here preaching the word of God. Amen? Amen? And we've got other children who have managed to preach to their parents. Some parents, we never used to see them here. But because of their children, we are seeing them every week. So we thank God for that. Amen? So the young guys, the young children, even those who have visited us this today, we are inviting you. We meet here. Normally we meet every second week of the month. Amen? But do you know what? The youth, they've encouraged us that we want to meet every week. Is that correct? Yeah. Amen? You can hear from them. Amen? So they want us to meet every week. And we are preparing something like a youth day. But we are meeting here every week. And we want ideas. We want information. We want so many of these youth to come here. So those who have visited us today, please, you are welcome. We meet here every Saturday. And if you want transport, I'm available to pick you up. Amen? Amen. And I'll drop you back. Amen? Amen? So we meet here on Saturday from 5:30 to 7. Amen? So my brother, we are also inviting you. Amen. Because we want your voice here. Amen, amen, for the convention and for the preaching. Who knows what you're going to do? Amen? So we are inviting you all, and those who would want transport, I'm available to pick you up and drop you back. And what else can I say? And those who have got talents, because there's some hidden talents in most of us, amen? But unless you expose those, God can use you, amen? And God can use anybody. It doesn't matter whether you're short, you're tall, you're fat, you're slim, or whether you have not been to school, whether you can't even, I like Joyce Meyer, she's saying, God can use anybody. Even if you don't know what you're supposed to do, just do everything. So start from ushering, cleaning the toilets, anything in the house of God. By doing so, you'll find what really God called you to do. Amen? So I'm inviting you, the youth, and those who need transport, I'm available. Amen? Amen. Thank you so much.